Shell elements is a great way to speed up calculation time, and it can be used when the span thickness ratio is larger than 20 and we can ignore the shear deformation and stress in the through thickness direction. In this video, I will show you three ways to generate shell elements in SOLIDWORKS Simulation. The first method is to use the already existing geometry, so I'll just create a new study and I'll give it a proper name. Then I can right click the part and select Define Shell by Selected Faces. Then I will go ahead and pick the faces that I want to have as a bottom of my shell. Then I'll set it to the right thickness, which is 1.2 in this case, and click OK. Now I can see that I have a shell definition in my feature tree, and if I go ahead and mesh the part, I can see that it's the final shell and that the face selected is orange, which means they are the bottom face. The second method is to insert surface bodies. So I'll do that by using mid surface. But if I try to create a mid surface on a fillet such as here, I will get an error message because it's not an exact offset from the first. Therefore, I'll suppress my fillets in this case. Then I'll go ahead and use the mid-surface again, and I will let SOLIDWORKS find those pairs for me by clicking Find Surface Pairs. Then I can create a new simulation. I'll give it a proper name again. And then I'll exclude the solid body from the simulation and edit the definition of the surface body to have it in the right thickness. So this is automatically treated as a shell. Then I can go ahead and mesh my model again. And as you can see, I have the same mesh as I had earlier. The third method is to model it as a sheet metal using sheet metal features. So I'll create a new study. When you click OK, you can see that it's already treated as a shell, and if I edit the definition, you can see that the thickness is imported from my sheet metal parameters.